गुड मॉर्निंग गर्ल्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंप्लीट अवर टॉपिक कॉल्ड एज सिंगल एंट्री सिस्टम अकाउंटिंग. इन द लास्ट क्लासेस आई वाज बीन एक्सप्लेनिंग यू विद ए सिंपलेस्ट प्रॉब्लम्स वेयर वी आर बीन कैलकुलेटिंग हाउ टू फाइंड आउट द प्रॉफिट और लॉस मेड बाय ए बिजनेस व्हेन दे डोंट मेंटेन द बुक्स ऑफ अकाउंट्स अंडर द डबल एंट्री सिस्टम. दैट इज दे विल यूज सिंगल एंट्री मेथड, कैपिटल एट द बिगिनिंग, कैपिटल एट द एंड, ड्रॉइंग्स, एडिशनल कैपिटल. सो व्हेन ए प्रॉब्लम इज गिवन टू यू डायरेक्टली, कैपिटल एट द बिगिनिंग, कैपिटल एट द एंड, ड्रॉइंग्स एंड एडिशनल कैपिटल, वी विल डायरेक्टली इंप्लीमेंट इन आवर प्रोफॉर्मा एंड विल कैलकुलेट द प्रॉफिट और लॉस. इन द सेम मैनर व्हेन एनी ऑफ द missing part of the problem is given to you, we will find that in our method only. But another way of calculating a profit and loss under single entry system is when the capitals are not given to you. That means a businessman doesn't give you any capital, that is either at the beginning of the year or either at the end of the year, but they will give you certain information regarding assets and liabilities. So with the help of assets and liabilities, we will try to calculate what is the profit or loss. You know, assets and liabilities means the definition given for capital. Assets and liabilities are used for finding out the capitals, the investment, the initial investment made by the business in the initial investment made by the businessman in the business is known as capital. That may be his own income or that may be borrowed income also. Out of his own income, if you remove borrowed income, we will find capital. So, when the information is given to you regarding assets and liabilities, we will prepare a small balance sheet. It will not be a proper if you use the word called as a balance sheet because we are not doing under the double entry system. When we are doing under the single entry system, the word balance sheet is replaced with another word called as statement of assets. That means keeping all the assets on one side of the account or statement and putting all the liabilities on the other side of the statement will give you what is the position of the business. From the assets, if you remove liabilities, the balance will go into call it as a capital. Otherwise, accounting equation is equal to capital is equal to assets minus liabilities. We will use like this. So, to calculate capital on both the days, the capital is not given on the 1st of April as well as the capital is not given on the 31st of March. So, there is no capitals given to you readymadely, but a financial position regarding the assets and liabilities are given to you on 1st April and 31st of March at the beginning of the year as well as the end of the year. We will try to prepare a statement of assets, that is putting the assets on one side and putting the liabilities on another side or opposite side. From that asset total, we will minus the liability total and we calculate the capital. Once you get the capital on 1/4 as well as on the 31st of March, we will complete our calculation process. Okay, so see here, statement of affairs of Sai Kiran as on 1st April 2014 that is beginning. We will draw a small pro forma showing our assets on one side and showing the liabilities on another side. Assets amount column, liabilities. Now from the information given to you here on the problem, we will try to recognize which is your asset and which is your liability. Accordingly, we are going to take these amounts on that side. Debtor, it is an asset. So asset will come on the debit side, the asset will come on the asset side in the balance sheet. So debtors 12,000. Then creditors, it is a liability, it should come on the liability side. Stock, it is an asset, so we will show it on the asset side. Furniture is an asset. $20,000. Then cash is an asset. We'll write it on the asset side. Machinery is an asset. We'll write it on the asset side. Investment is an asset. 11,000. So with this, we completed posting of the figures related to 1/4/2014. Assets on the asset side, liabilities on the liability side. We'll do the total for this. We'll put it on both the sides. 88,000, we are getting the total. Same total, we put it on both the sides. Once again, we check the total. From this 88,000, we minus the 34,000 because our accounting equation says capital is equal to assets minus liabilities. So we'll call it here capital. That is 88,000 minus your 34,000. So 0, 4, 8 minus 3, 5. 54,000 is your capital at the beginning of your accounting period. One part of a capital we found out, that is beginning capital. Now we'll find out in the same manner for our ending capital also, and we'll complete of the second capital also. Statement of affairs of Sarkiran as on 31st March 2015. This is ending. So this is our assets. This is your rupees, liabilities, rupees. Now again, debtors. Debtors will come on the asset side. That is 25,000. Creditors is a liabilities, 40,000. Stock, asset, we'll take it on the asset side. 35,000. Furniture, 25,000 asset. Then cash, cash is an asset, we take it on the asset side, cash 22,000. Machinery is an asset, we take it on the asset side, 18,000. Then we have a last item called as investment is an asset, 15,000. Now we will do the total for this and we will find out what is your 10, 15, 20, 30. So we got the total 1,40,000. Same 1,40,000, we will write it on both the sides and we will find out the capital here. Our capital is equal to assets minus liabilities, that is 1,40,000 minus 40,000 will give you 1,00,000. Now we got both the capitals in our hand. We have the capital at the beginning, we also have the capital at the end. Now we will find out what is the profit or loss made under single entry system. Calculation of profit or loss under single entry system. So we start with capital at the end. We have the capital at the end is 1,00,000 rupees. For this 1,00,000, we will add drawings made. That is not given for us in the problem. So 1,00,000 again we will get the balance. Again for that we will minus fresh or additional capital introduced. Fresh capital introduced. So it is not given for us in the problem. Again 1,00,000 rupees. We will call this as a net adjusted capital. From this we will deduct capital at the end. Capital at the beginning, sorry. That we have 54,000. So your profit is 46,000 under single entry. This is net profit. So, just now we have seen the problem of Mr. Sankiran where the capital at the beginning and capital at the end are not given for us. They gave you the information regarding the assets and liabilities. With the help of that assets and liabilities, we calculated the capital at the beginning and we also calculated the capital at the end of the year and we found out how to calculate the profit of single entry system. Now, we are going to see a last problem. Where? See this problem. Subhash started his business on 1st April 2010 with a capital of 60,000. On 1st April 2010, Subhash is starting his business with how much capital? 60,000. But on 31st of March 2011, his assets and liabilities were as follows. On 31st March 2011, the Subhash assets and liabilities were like this. And during the year, he withdrawn 6,000 rupees. With this information, they are asking you to prepare the profit or loss under single entry system. So in this problem, we have given with the capital at the beginning, but we are not given with the capital at the end. So, we need not to prepare two statement of affairs. We need to prepare only one statement of affair, that is on 31st March 2011. Because already we are having on 1st April 2010 capital of 60,000. That is the beginning capital. So, ending capital is on 31st of March. So this ending capital only we have to find out by preparing statement of affairs and then calculating the profit and loss. So solution: statement of affairs of Mr. Subhash as on 31st March 2011. This is ending one. Assets, liabilities. So once again I will repeat why we are preparing the statement of affairs only on 31st March 2011. Because the capital at the beginning is given for us readymadely calculated figure in the problem. So we need not to prepare two statements of affairs. We need to prepare only one statement of affairs, that is on 31st March 2011. We will call that as a closing. So furniture, it is an asset. We will write it on the asset side. Cash. Cash is an asset. 12,000. Bills payable, liability 9,000. Then creditors, liability 9,000. Then we have machinery, asset 20,000. Then we have stock. Stock is an asset 12,000. Then debtors is an asset 23,000. So we calculated what is statement of affairs. We have posted all the items according to their nature, that is whether it is an asset or liability. If it is an asset, we have written on the asset side. If it is a liability, we have written on the liability side. Now we will do the total. 10, 15, 15, 1, 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 85,000. 85,000 is the highest total on the asset side. Same total we will write it on the opposite side also, that is 85,000. Now we will find out the capital here. Capital is equal to 85,000 minus 9 plus 11, 20,000. So your capital at the end is 65,000. Now you got the capital at the beginning, you got the capital at the end. Now we will find out what is the profit or loss made. Calculation of profit or loss under single entry system. Capital at the end. Our capital at the end is 65,000. For this capital, we will add drawings made. Drawings made during the year. How much is the drawings made by Mr. Subhash during the year? 6,000. We will add here. It will become 71,000. From this, we will remove additional or fresh capital. There is no additional or fresh capital in the problem. So, 71,000 is your net adjusted capital. From that, we need to minus capital at the beginning, which is already given to you, 60,000. So, less capital at the beginning 16,000. So net adjusted capital is more for you, 11,000 is your net profit. So we are going for the last problem in our chapter. Mr. Pawan started his business on 1st April 2014 with a capital of 50,000. This 50,000 is called as a capital at the beginning because Pawan has started the business on 1st April 2014. You see the date, you try to understand what is being given in the question. You try to understand the simple English language statement. Pawan started his business. Pawan is not running the business earlier. He just started newly concerned on 1st April 2014. So when you start the business, the amount which you invest minimum or initial in the business on the date of starting the business, we will call that as a capital. But a slight change we will do here for that capital. On what date is starting the business? 1st April. So on 1st April, it is our accounting period date, starting date. So the capital invested on this date will be called as a beginning capital. So the capital at the beginning is given for you. Now what is not given? His assets and liabilities are given on 31st March. His assets and liabilities are given on 31st of March. So the capital at the beginning is given, whereas capital at the end is not given. Instead of giving the capital at the end, he has given you assets and liabilities, cash, debtors, stock, furniture, bills receivable, bills payable, and creditors. These all are called as your assets and liabilities. With the help of these assets and liabilities, we will prepare statement of affairs and we will try to find out what is the capital at the end of the year. So we write here Mr. Pawan. His accounting period is 2015. So debtors 16,000. Then we have cash 6,000. Then we have bills receivable 5,000. Then we have stock 18,000. Then we have furniture 30,000. Then creditors 15,000. Then we have bills payable 7,000. So machinery is not given for us in the problem. We will try to erase that. So do the total. What is the total here? We will see. 6 plus 5, 11. 11 plus 8, 19, 25. 5, 2, 4, 5, 6, 7. 75,000. Same 75,000, we write it here. 75,000 minus 22,000. So 0, 0, 0. 5 minus 2, 3. 7 minus 2, 5. 53,000. So capital at the end is 53,000. Drawings is not given for us in the problem. We put net 53,000. Additional capital is also not given for us. Net adjusted capital 53,000. From this net adjusted capital, capital at the beginning is given for us 50,000. So your net profit made by the business is 3,000. That's all. So thus, I will try to conclude my subject and single entry chapter today by putting a full stop on these problems, because if you try to practice the problems which are given similar type in a Telugu Academy book, in a Telugu Academy book on page number 62, 63, 64, will make you to practice the problems. And if you have any type of doubts, clarifications or any type of help, you can contact us or you can reply us by the way giving as a comment. Thank you.